La Squab. I want this to be like Alice in Wonderland on a warm day in Oxford, by way of Wind in the Willows, said Lord Horror to the young La Squab. And all shall be well, and all manner of things shall be well, when the tongues of flame are enfolded into the crowned knot of fire, and the fire and the roses are one. T.S. Eliot, Four Quartets. Some days are bluer and hotter than others. Horror thought this day was just perfect, but not for long. The Oxford sky was heron blue, and the summer butterflies lazily hummed in its afternoon heat. Along the riverbank's cool penumbra and balmy air, he could hear the sweet emoting tones of Squab, singing longingly to a continued future argosy of potential adventure. Good morning, little sweetheart caw. I've enjoyed every minute with you. I know that the stars up in heaven are all getting jealous of me too. The parting will make me so blue. Doodaloo, doodaloo, to you. Though after you've gone, memories linger on. Good morning, little sweetheart. Good morning, brave car. The sun was a red fingerprint impression splashed across the corduroy blue sky as Horror the Gimp limped along a rocky road to where Squab was turning Levoltos with a whirligig spinning erratically on the palm of her hand. It's such a nice day. Now watch some bastard come and spoil it. Of all the vexations of the world on offer, thought Horror, his eyes fixing on the bright chassis of Herbie Schopenhauer, the flying Volkswagen Beetle, the last thing he wanted to confront was the sexy zing of a naive car. The rich, fruity voice of Herbie putt-putted amorously down to fall in raptures on young Squab. Oh, the stars shone bright as I held Squab tight during the night, and I heard her say, please don't ever go away. And I held her in my arms, told her of her many charms, and kissed her while the fiddlers played Bonaparte's Retreat. Irritated by the indignities and injustices of the world, Herbie had found a comfortable retreat in the machinations of amour. His sliding tongue licked warmly through the grills at the front of his bonnet, while he rolled and swaggered through the air like a couple of swells pin-topping. Most charming, I'm sure, stated Herbie.
You don't know whether to say something saucepot or not, Squab giggled.
One Friday in April, Squab fell in love with everything living inside automobiles. It was a moony sort of love. She mooched. She was a girl with romantic thoughts. Soon, all she really lusted for was Herbie. You have guessed my plight right, actually, Herbie nodded towards Mr. Horror. Certainly not with other ears listening. The little car's wing mirrors rattled. Well, strap me and Heil Hitler. Love cannot escape me. I'm as happy as a sandboy on a happy car.
Gosh, how thrilling last night was,
cooed Squab. Wasn't it? In later years, Herbie said slowly, when you have seen as much as I have, you may be tempted to grow sentimental over moments such as these.
Moments such as what? Squab ventured.
This, Herbie said. All of this. The smell of grass, the warmth of the sun, the sound of water, the hurly of our lovemaking. It can all become fodder for adult memories.
You will always have a special spot in my heart, Squab promised, catching the sweet odor of opium and Virginia tobacco, mixing faint-heartedly with the smell of the river silt.
My heart beats to the rhythm of the spheres, declared the Volkswagen earnestly. My love is a huge engine, and if love leaves me, steam piped unconsolably from his exhaust, it does not stop the engine roaring.
Your sentiments are appreciated.
If you two lovebirds don't mind, can we get back to the job in hand? Horror wiped a large mayfly and an even bigger predatory damselfly nymph from his face. If you can spare a minute, if you don't mind. Excuse me, my dear, what was I saying?
Herbie blinked his headlamps.
That the lower orders are too dull to have anything worth saying, lied Squab.
Really? How very stern of me. Still, I was probably right. Nobody can invoke a spring morning quite like Elgar or Schumann. For example, Das Paradies und die Peri, part of a series of cantatas that Schumann composed to celebrate his boyhood passion for mythology.
You don't say.
Not to mention Leoncavallo.
Who?
He wrote a magnificent opera about real human beings who deceive each other and then dress as clowns and kill each other. Grounded in human nature, you see.
The Volkswagen's laughter unexpectedly turned the day cold. You suss people out quickly, don't you?
That doesn't take the truth away from yourself and what you have to give if you feel the beauty police are after you, putting the finger on you, saying, no, you're not good enough. Your wheel should not be on the road. With such thoughts abroad, how can you relax and say something kind about the world?
You can try, for goodness sake. Look how lovely and kind you were last night. Your kisses were sweet molasses. Your pipe like a hollowed-out pumpkin filled with milk, spices, and honey.
Squab's eyes gleamed more indomitably than ever. My little envelope of individualism. Hear all, see all, say nout, mon amour. Herbie broke into a spirited version of Billy Merson's Yakky Hicky Doola.
Now, it's no use your playing that game of sleight of hand with me. I'm up to your evading tricks, dear car. Say those sly words of fact which will brighten my socks, cause me to arc my back and stir the bowl of my juices.
Earth and copulation and death. When you come to brass tacks, that's all the facts you need to know.
Haughtily, steam sneaking from his exhaust pipe, giving moisture to the river bank. He flicked the waters to give blurry impressions of movement among the deep reeds, suggesting below the water was the home of Monet's Nymphaeus.
That's all, that's all, that's all, that's all.
Enough! You're not the automobile you were last night. Though I will always cherish our intimate liaison and appreciate your amorous technique.
Squab supped thirstily from a can of tangerine crush.
I am grieved to my steel chassis. I am jealous as a Turk and don't give a fig or a straw hat who knows it. If I should lose your affection, your sweet breath on my fender, I would commit a beastly act of cruelty. By point of order, now I feel strongly disposed to assassinate everybody who does not keep out of my reach.